A beautiful spring day, blue skies and sunshine with northeasterly winds picking up this afternoon. Temperatures were close to average, reaching 24 in Richmond and Penrith, 22 in Blacktown and Liverpool, 19 in Terre Hills and 21 in the city and in Cronulla. Our marine life certainly enjoying the spring conditions. Two whales spotted splashing around 500 metres off Cape Bailey Lighthouse. That was in Kurnell this morning. The northern rivers saw some storms this morning. That brought a few light showers, while southern inland areas also saw some storms and showers moving this afternoon as a cold front moved through. But we did see some very warm temperatures ahead of that front today, with dry, warm and gusty winds over the northwest. Bourke hit 33 degrees, 32 in Walgett and Moree. That's their warmest September day in 4 years. Tomorrow, a front will clip the southwest corner of WA. That will generate some gusty showers, while another front will cross Tasmania, a high keeping New South Wales mainly dry. Brisbane will be fine, a warm 30 degrees, sunny in Canberra, top of 16, partly cloudy skies in Melbourne and Hobart, and a few showers on the way for Adelaide and Perth. Some very summery weather expected in northern New South Wales tomorrow, heading for 33 in Grafton, 29 in Coffs Harbour, but southern New South Wales will be much, much cooler, heading for a top of just 15 in Albury, 16 in Wagga Wagga and Bathurst, and there is a strong wind warning for the south coast as well as Byron and Coffs Harbour. After a possible light shower in the early morning, Sydney will be mostly sunny tomorrow, but it will be windy along the coast with moderate to fresh westerlies. We're heading for tops of 23 to 24 degrees right across our western suburbs, including Penrith, Liverpool and Campbelltown, 24 for Gosford, 22 in Terre Hills and Cronulla and 23 in the city. Let's take a look ahead, and Wednesday will be sunny, a top of 21 degrees. Thursday looking absolutely beautiful, sunny and 26 degrees. It will cool back down on Friday with partly cloudy skies, but we're still heading for a top of 21, a cooler 17 on Saturday. Partly cloudy and 20 degrees on Sunday, and tonight will be the warmest night for the next 7 days, only dipping to 14. In our west, sunshine right through to the weekend, Thursday hitting a summery 30 degrees before a cool change moves through on Friday, and we'll see a top of 21, 19 on Saturday, and those nights ranging from a low of 11 tonight down to 4 degrees by Sunday, Pete.
Amber, thank you.
Well, Gary's back now with your full forecast. Gaz, it was warm today, but we're expecting a hot one tomorrow.
Oh, we certainly are, Andrew. Look, the rest of the week will be warm, but tomorrow will be the hottest day of the week. We're looking at 30 degrees here in Brizzy and about 33 for Ipswich. So anywhere from the city west into the 30s, and even warm on the coast, some strengthening northerly winds tomorrow, even a strong wind warning for the Gold Coast waters and offshore. And we're likely to see the storms fire up towards the afternoon tomorrow, fueled by those strengthening northerly winds. Now, let's have a look at temperatures, where it was quite warm overnight. Even Brisbane only dropped to 17 degrees. Now that helped fuel those early morning thunderstorms, while daytime temperatures range from 22 in Redlands up to 26 in Caboolture, 23 for Coolangatta, 25 for the Gold Coast, Brisbane, Archerfield, Ipswich, Greenbank, Logan and the Sunny Coast. To the weather map, gusty showers across the southwest of WA. A cold front will generate westerly winds in its wake, pushing showers onto western Tassie, while a trough over southeast Queensland likely to produce showers and storms once again. Interstate, looking at our capitals and major centres, showers in Perth, Adelaide and Melbourne. A mostly sunny day for Sydney in 23, sunny and low 30s on the way for Alice Springs and also Darwin. So for Queensland for Tuesday, sunny and high 20s for Cairns, Townsville, Mackay and Gladstone. Low 30s for Rocky and Gympie, high 20s in Bundy and Maryborough, sunny and hot inland. We're looking at 34 on the way for Longreach and 32 in Roma. Here in the southeast, it'll be a partly cloudy day, just the chance of those afternoon showers and storms. In strengthening north to northwesterly winds, it will push daytime temperatures into the low 30s inland, high 20s for the coast and bayside suburbs. Moreton Bay, the northerlies, 15 to 20 knots, reaching 20 to 25 by the afternoon. So the sea's 1 to 2 metres on the bay, but 2 to 3 metres offshore. Brisbane, partly cloudy, strengthening northwesterlies, the chance of those late storms, a top of 30 degrees and mild overnight, a low of 16. 7 day outlook, sunny Wednesday 27, Thursday 27 with the chance of a late storm, Friday 28 with possible late storms, partly cloudy weekend with 24 Saturday and 23 Sunday due to southerly winds kicking back in. Ipswich, Wednesday fine and 29, Thursday 29, possible showers and storms, mostly sunny Friday and 31 with a chance of late storms, partly cloudy and just cooling back to the mid 20s over the weekend. For the Goldie, Wednesday 26 and sunny, Thursday, starting out fine. Chance of late storms with 26. Friday, fine. Possible late storms and 27. A possible shower over the weekend with low 20s. The Sunshine Coast, there is the chance of afternoon showers and storms across Wednesday, Thursday and Friday with mid-20s. A little cloud over the weekend as southerly winds start to kick back in and temperatures dropping back down to the low 20s. So a hot one tomorrow. We can blame those northerly winds. It will feel quite a bit warmer in that breeze. And just keep an eye to the sky in the afternoon, particularly with those thunderstorms likely to fire up very late in the day.
We'll keep a lookout for them. Thanks, Gary.
Hello again. Spring has wasted no time in warming things up. The city peaked at 22 degrees this afternoon. It reached the 20s almost right across Melbourne. Ferny Creek almost there with 19. And Werribee, Epping, Moorabbin and Yarra Glen did even better than the city, warming up to 23. It has been very windy though, especially at the airport. It clocked 89 kilometres an hour just before lunchtime. Most suburbs recorded gusts of more than 50, but winds did ease in the afternoon. And after that, the showers arrived. Western suburbs haven't recorded anything, but there's been 5 millimetres in eastern suburbs and almost 11 further out. The showers moved into the west of the state before lunchtime. The band has been travelling across quite quickly. There was a westerly wind change behind them, and that kept the southwest of the state to maximums of 15 and 16 degrees. But most of northern and eastern Victoria warmed up into the low to mid 20s. Gippsland has been the warmest spot, 25 degrees at Orbost and Sale. The showers will clear out through the east of the state tonight, and another band will follow behind, but that's expected to weaken and only deliver a few isolated falls tomorrow, mostly through the south. More showers will approach from the west on Wednesday, but before they arrive, we'll get a gap day with sunny skies, but like today, some gusty northerly winds. Tomorrow, Brisbane is forecast to reach 30 degrees for the first time since April. Sydney's heading for a sunny top of 23, 16 for Canberra, Hobart and Adelaide. And Perth should get a few showers on its way to a top of 21. Back home, it'll be quite a chilly night for inland areas and a frost warning for the Northern Country District. And under westerly breezes, daytime temperatures will be 5 to 7 degrees lower than today, mostly the mid to high teens. Showers will continue through Melbourne's eastern suburbs tonight, clearing before midnight. Then light showers will pick up again tomorrow morning around 8, but they should clear in the late morning. There is the chance of thunderstorms in southeastern suburbs. The window for that is 10 a.m. until 2 p.m. After a very chilly night, it's only expected to reach 14 or 15 tomorrow. There's only the slight chance of Geelong picking up a shower, and after a low of 5, it's heading for 15. The city is also heading for 15 after an overnight low of 7. We'll be back under partly cloudy skies on Wednesday, and it'll be warmer as well, 19 degrees, but winds will increase throughout the day. Showers, possible hail on Thursday, 17 degrees, but that temperature will drop off quite quickly at night. Down to 8 degrees on Friday morning, then a top of just 12 with showers on and off throughout the day. 14 on Saturday with the chance of a shower, 15 on Sunday, 17 and partly cloudy next Monday. Showers will continue across Melbourne tonight, clearing before midnight, before a few pop up again tomorrow morning, a low of 7 and a top of 15. Spring just loves mixing things up, Pete.
You're absolutely right.